Good day, everyone. So for today's review, I will show to you the factors of movement, the concept of movement, and the law of movement.
The factors of movement. First is weight. The exercise is lunge. Lunge exercise. Increase muscle mass to build up strength and tone your body, especially your core, back, and legs. Improving your appearance isn't the main benefit of shaping up your body, as you will also improve your posture and range of motion. Lunges target the following muscles: abdominals. The second factors of movement is flow. The exercise is side kick. Side kick exercise works all the major lower body muscle groups, particularly the quads, glutes, and outer thighs. Side kicks also automatically use the muscles of our core. We call this reactive core training, where our core gets stronger because the side kick forces these muscles to automatically respond. The first concept of movement is body awareness. The exercise is plank. Plank exercise. It strengthens your core. It improves muscles definition. It aids your metabolic rate. It helps towards improving your posture. It helps with back pain. It is great for core muscle stability, and it works more than just your core muscles. The second concept of movements is spatial awareness. The exercise is moving block jump. Moving block jump. It helps you to make bone faster, increase your muscle mass to build up strength and tone your body, especially your core, butt, and legs. Strengthens all the muscles in your legs, gets your heart rate up, and improves momentum, coordination, and flexibility. The first law of movement is form. The exercise is squat. Squat exercise strengthens your core, reduces the risk of injury, crushes calories, strengthens the muscles of your lower body, boosts athletic ability and strength. Variety helps with motivation and can be done anywhere. The second law of movement is extension. The exercise is back extension. Back extension exercise. Performing back extension exercise will increase your ability to coordinate movement through your lower back. Other improvements include a stronger back and a back that has more endurance. Overall, these positives lead to better overall back posture, important for the prevention of back injury. The third law of movement is velocity. The exercise is high knees. High knees exercise are a cardio-intensive exercise performed at all fast pace. It engages your core, strengthens all the muscles in your legs, gets your heart rate up, and improves momentum, coordination, and flexibility. Because of the many physical benefits, high knees are incorporated into a wide variety of workouts. The fourth law of movement is motion. The exercise is leg raise. Leg raise exercise helps to lose weight from the legs and lower abdomen, tones, strengthens muscles in your abdomen and legs, an effective exercise for lower abs, can strengthen the hamstrings, calf muscles and glutes, and it is a great exercise that can be done even while lying down in bed. The fifth law of movements is sequence. The exercise is sequence balance. Sequence balance exercise can help build strength and improve posture, stability, and coordination. And it is effective for postural and neuromuscular control improvement.